हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अभिपीडिया पावर्ड बाय अभिमन्यु आईएएस. दिस इज़ द 12th लेक्चर ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक वैल्यू एडिशन सीरीज विद डॉक्टर विवेक राणा. वी आर डिस्कसिंग थीम्स एंड टॉपिक्स विच आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स 2020 पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. एंड टॉपिक फॉर दिस लेक्चर इज़ टूडे 107th इंडियन साइंस कांग्रेस. Like always, in the first week of January, there is an important congregation of scientists, and even the political dignitaries grace their presence to address the scientific gathering and set the tone for new year. So this year, 107th Science Congress has been concluded. It was from January 3 to 7. So here we are bringing you the highlights of Indian Science Congress, the history behind Indian Science Congress, and like always, a practice question to just give you a feel that what kind of theme can be asked from this section. So this Science Congress is to be followed from pre point of view. If the examiner wants to frame a question, he might ask you some factual topics about the history, and from mains point of view, the theme which has been discussed holds importance. So let's start without wasting any time. So 107th Science Congress has just been concluded, and we will be starting with the key highlights of this summit. So first of all, we have to understand that what is the edition. As I have said, this is the 107th edition of Indian Science Congress. It shows that science and technology has been prospering in India from times immemorial, but this formal congregation is from British era itself, and its legacy has been continuing in the after independence as well. And the venue for this year has been the Garden City, Bengaluru. And this city is not holding this summit for the first time. It's the ninth time it has a privilege of hosting this grand summit. And inauguration this time was by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And he had some inputs to share, which we'll be discussing in highlight part. And then coming to the theme is the most important part from this 107th Indian Science Congress. The theme for this year is Science and Technology, Rural Development. So this is the theme which sets the tone for this year. We have to capitalize on technology to boost our agricultural incomes and to transform lives of rural people. As it's mentioned in our UPSC syllabus as well, that we have to follow science and technology, their socio-economic developments and their impact on everyday life. So this theme caters to it. So make sure your mind is already synergizing to this theme, that how science and tech is revolutionizing the rural or agriculture sector, which holds our economy by employing directly or indirectly over 50% of population. So objective of this year's summit is the follow-up of the theme. It wants to bridge the gap between technology developers and rural population. Even though in last decade we have seen some major developments which have contributed to increasing the agriculture crop productivity, increasing the market access, as well as changing the livelihood opportunities for millions of people. But yet the opportunity remains partially explored, and there is a huge potential to transform lives. We have come a long way. When a smartphone or this fast-speed internet was a privilege for some sections of the society, but today the revolution has made it possible for every man to use this technology with ease. But the content as well as the real benefit is yet to be accrued, and this is what this technology is trying to bridge this year. So we have to understand that, make sure you are trying to recollect whatever science and tech developments are in field of agriculture should be noted down, because the question can be asked that how artificial intelligence can contribute, what is the role of space technology in changing the agriculture scenario, what could be the likely impact of ICT applications which we are currently harnessing. So this is what sets the tone for this year 107th Indian Science Congress. So let's just go back a time that how this Indian Science Congress has come into being. I'll be discussing some few facts because these themes are generally not covered in newspaper. Even though the venue part, the theme part, the inauguration part are highlighted, this history is rarely mentioned in the newspaper. So all of those who are new, I'm just brushing your facts up to it. So this journey of Indian Science Congress can be traced back to the years long back in 1914, when two British chemists, the names which you are seeing on your screen, the Simonson as well as P.S. McMahon, this was the brainchild of them. They wanted a congregation so that a roadmap could be devised for a future course of action, and then this science and technology which should be promoted could get the impetus. So scientific temper is what it was aiming at, and the very humble objectives which you are seeing on the screen were the main agenda of Indian Science Congress Association. And they wanted to have a clear-cut venue every year so that the best minds can go there and share their visionary ideas. And this, you have to understand that, like this year it's Bengaluru, the venue keeps on changing. It's not that every year it will be at the same place. Over the year, if you will go through the various editions, you will see almost all parts have been there. Okay, even the last edition was in LPU in Punjab itself. So make sure you are aware of the venues as well. Then they want to publish the scientific journals as well as other scientific documents so that the young minds could read them and contribute to the research and development. Also, the main impetus was to mobilize and streamline the funds which can be used for further scientific development through this Congress, which it is always catering to. So this is what this Indian Science Congress is all about. And the first ever summit was historically in Calcutta. In Calcutta, you have to understand Sir Ashutosh Mukherjee, the then Vice Chancellor of Calcutta University, was the presided over it. So that is what history of Indian Science Congress has been. So what are the highlights of this year's Indian Science Congress? The 107th edition was conducted in University of Agriculture Sciences, Bengaluru. And the three key highlights have been, the first one is that iSTEM portal has been launched. Now, what is this iSTEM portal? This is Indian Science and Technology Engineering map, which has been designed specifically so that the researchers all over India can easily locate the facilities which they require for accomplishing their research and development. So it's a great initiative which will likely to help a lot of scientific minds in future. Then Prime Minister Modi presided over the Congress, and he gave a slogan for this year, and the motto which sets the tone is innovate, patent, produce and prosper. So these are the positive theme on which the vision is to work on. And because in patents, India has been a laggard over the years, but over the last 2-3 years, there has been some impetus and more patents have started to come up. So this is what it is. We have to innovate, prosper, and even though there are a lot of challenges and research, there's a lot of competition, but we should rise on the occasion and make this opportunity count, because new year is always sets the tone for a new decade, and this is the right moment where we should excel. And he also had said that the growth story of India will depend on achievements of in science and technology. So this is one of the theme in which your comments can always be asked in UPSC as well, or essay could be asked, that the growth of Indian economy or Indian growth story in 21st century more or less rest on scientific development. So it's a likely theme for essays as well on which you could work on. And like always, these science congresses are presided over or are attended by some Nobel laureates. This year, the Nobel laureates were Stephen Hale and Ada Yonath. Stephen Hale has won Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 2014 for his revolutionary fluorescent microscopy technique. It is popularly known as STEM microscopy. And Ada Yonath in 2009 shared Nobel laureate with our own Venkatraman Ramakrishnan, which we had covered in our class lectures as well. Venkatraman Ramakrishnan and Ada Yonath had worked on structure of ribosomes. And ribosomes, we know in biology, are our protein factories. So it's a cell biology topic which has just been activated once again. So make sure these are some associated topics which you should be familiar with, because at times the distant linkage is drawn and UPSC surprises you with the option. So make sure you revise the all cell biology part, which is our biology first lecture as well. And to conclude it with a practice question, overall the scientific journey has been highlighted in Indian Science Congress as well. Like, India's growth rate in science and technology at the moment is 10%, which is more than global average of 4%, which is a positive sign. In innovative index also, we have improved our ranking. We are at 52. Yes, we can do much better than that, but for that we have to work and upgrade our research and development and file more and more patents for new technology. Okay. So this is it. So the question is a straightforward one, and today's practice question is within the context of the lecture. If you have heard this lecture with attention, there is no reason you cannot attempt this. Almost all options have been clearly discussed. So yes, we have to choose the incorrect option. The first option is the obvious one, that Bengaluru is hosting the 107th Indian Science Congress. As I have highlighted multiple times, yes, it's the host for 107th Congress. It's the correct option. The theme which we have discussed elaborately is science and technology, rural development. So B option is automatic choice. The third one is the wrong one, because this is not the second time that Bengaluru is hosting it. Bengaluru has distinction of hosting this annual convention for the 9th time. So you have to understand, it was quite obvious, its journey has been so long, and Bengaluru, Hyderabad, these are the cities which are excelling in science and tech. So there's no reason that they have not hosted long back as well. And finally, the first session of 1914 Asiatic Society, Calcutta, is also the correct one. So this is it for now. The Indian Science Congress, make sure you could jot the key points from this session. And the rural development theme is the one area on which you can work on or own. So that's it for now. I'll be back soon with another Science and Tech Value Addition series soon. Keep following. You could subscribe and share your comments in the comment section. Thank you very much.